not going to see it. So you may feel more pressure into the table. That's going posterior. But according to the diagrams and from the smart people who came up with these theories, it's going down to the table. Because they make this theory like a clock, like a gear. So this gear, if this is the occiput, is going down to the table. What you're going to feel will be, if I hold him this way, and we're going to do a hold like this, what I'm going to feel, if I exaggerate, this is extension. Pressure into the table. This is flexion. Pressure into the table. Okay? This is extension. Flexion, extension. And if you just feel like the balloon, something getting bigger and then something getting smaller, that's okay. Whatever you feel is what it is. Whatever happens that you're feeling with the patient, that is what it is. And I also believe, this is maybe jumping ahead a little bit, but when if I'm touching him, there's going to be some interaction that may be different if I-Man is touching him, okay, or if there is touching him. There's your energy, their energy, and then two energies together. If we were to photograph this with brilliant photography, we could watch it. We could watch the energetic interaction.
Do you think when you feel this movement on one person, it should be the same in another person?
No,
it's always different, right? Between people.
I know what I'm going to find reasonably that in most people it's going to be between 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, that kind of rate. But how that balloon deforms, it's a signature. It's a footprint. It's a voice print. It's a conversation I'm having with you now, today.
And can the rate change with the same person? In the beginning,
yes.
Slower, then it can faster, then it will change from hemisphere to the other.
Yes, but not too likely within that treatment. Are you going to feel a change in the rate? What you will feel, what I hope you feel, will be a change in the amplitude.
And
the amplitude, if I'm feeling this kind of motion, I hope you feel this kind of motion. Something that it goes through longer.
But the same way you feel it, right? If he comes, for example, today and tomorrow, and you didn't do any treatment, you just felt the movement, you will feel the same movement. It won't change. The amplitude will change, right?
My hope is that the amplitude will change during my treatment.
Okay.
And then tomorrow, it will still be good. If I take all these theories and I throw them all into the trash can, okay, throw them all away. There is a collagenous river between his inner sagittal suture. It is not fused. It isn't. If there's some motion that occurs there, and I allow normal motion to happen a little bit better, would you agree that he has a better chance of being healthier? How that health is, I don't know. Maybe his headache goes away. I've got autistic kids who never spoke a word. To go from nothing to full sentences. And then the parents are, what technique did you do to do that? No, there is not the technique to touch to turn on the autistic kid. Okay? There is kids who have tight heads, and then I try and loosen what I feel. And sometimes we see miracles, sometimes we see small miracles, and sometimes we see nothing. I treat kids with seizures, and I've seen them have more seizures after I've treated them.